Hello students, good morning. I hope you all are fine and safe at home. We were discussing the chapter current electricity, and in the last class we introduced certain new topics like internal resistance, terminal potential difference, EMF, etc. I hope you got the concept clearly, that is distinction between that EMF and potential difference, then the relation connecting terminal potential difference and EMF, which is given by what, V equal to E minus IR. When you understood what is lost volt, then we have derived an expression for internal resistance, the factors on which the internal resistance of a cell depends, so and so. We have discussed so many things, and today we will discuss the topic called combination of cells. Okay, combination of cells. So far we have discussed the combination of capacitors, then the combination of resistors. You know that we have studied two combinations for capacitors as well as resistors. They are series combination and what, parallel combination. Clear? Now today for cells we are dealing with three main combinations. They are, first one is series combination, second is parallel combination, and the third one is mixed grouping of cells. Okay, series combination, parallel combination, and mixed grouping of cells. Mixed grouping, which means it consists of both series as well as parallel combination. Understood? So first we will discuss the series combination of cells. First is series combination of cells. Before moving to this particular topic, we have discussed certain small equations, like first is the relation for current drawn from a cell, which is given by I equal to E by R plus R. You remember, right? So E is the EMF, R is the external resistance, and small r is the internal resistance of a cell. So I equal to E by R plus R. This is the maximum current drawn from a cell. Clear? Now the second equation is relating E and V, which is given by V is equal to E minus IR. V equal to E minus IR. These two equations you are aware of. Now we are moving to the series combination of cells, in which I am connecting a few cells like E1, E2, E3, etc. to EN. Okay, we are considering N cells. N cells. Clear? All are having the same EMF. So E1 is equal to E2 is equal to E3, etc. If I am taking, all are having the same EMF, which can be taken as E. Okay, let us assume like that. Now each cell is having an internal resistance. We have studied that. The resistance offered by the cell is called internal resistance. So each cell is having an internal resistance, like E1 is having R1, E2 is having R2, then E3 is having R3, like that. For N cells, it is having what, Rn resistance. Understand? Now if this internal resistance is also same, I can say that what, the total resistance, the effective resistance of this particular combination is what, R plus R plus R plus, etc. It will go like that, isn't it? If it is N cells, you will get N R. Clear? For example, if there are five cells are there, each is having a resistance of what, R. So I will take R plus R plus R plus R plus R, isn't it? So what is the answer? It is 5R. Like that, if it is having N cells, what is the effective resistance? If the cells are connected in series, it will be NR. Understand? So this is the effective resistance when the cells are connected in series. Now we have to look into the effective EMF when the cells are connected in series. Effective EMF when the cells are connected in series. Here, the effective EMF can be calculated by adding all the EMFs. Since all are having the same EMF, like resistance, I can add the EMF also. So, E plus E like that it will go. Clear? So, what is the final value? It will be NE. NE. Understand? So, effective EMF for series combination is NE and effective internal resistance for the series combination is NR. Understood? Why I took like this? Because all the cells are having, if all the cells are having the same EMF and same internal resistance and the cells are connected in series combination. Understood? Now, how it is connected in series combination? The negative terminal of one cell is connected to positive of the other cell. Like that, it is connected and N cells are there. We assume like N cells are there and then we are going to find an expression for the current drawn from the cell. Understood? Now, the general expression for current is I equal to E by R plus R. Now, you got the effective EMF and effective internal resistance. We are going to substitute into that relation. Understood? Okay. Okay. Now, in series connection, as I told, the cells are connected here like this. That is, the negative terminal is connected to positive of the next cell. Again, the negative of that cell is connected to positive of the another cell. Okay, like that it is connected. And then it is connected to an external resistance like R, capital R. Okay. Internal resistance is represented by small r and external resistance is represented as capital R. Now, these are the cells having EMF E. All cells are having the same EMF E. Now, all cells are having the same internal resistance also. As I told, the effective resistance of the combination, effective resistance means internal resistance of the combination is taken as NR. You understood how it, okay. Now, then effective EMF is given as NE. Effective EMF is NE. Understood? Now we are going to derive the expression for I, that is the current drawn from the cell, which is given by I is equal to, instead of E I can write NE. Clear? Now capital R plus NR. Understood? NE by R plus NR. Okay. Now listen, there are special cases. So this is the expression for the current drawn from the cell when the cells are connected in series combination. Clear? Now the first case is, if the external resistance is greater than, very much greater than the internal resistance, okay, external resistance is greater than internal resistance, this will turn to, that is R plus NR will be approximately equal to R. Why? Because NR is very much small. So, this term will get neglected. Understand? So, finally, this R plus NR is approximately equal to R. Okay. So, how can I write the expression? That is, I is equal to NE by R. Understood? NE by R. This is the first case. Clear? Now, for the second case, if I am taking, if this NR is very much greater than capital R, if NR is very much greater than capital R, how does this equation change? This R plus NR will change to, R plus NR will change to what? R, approximately equal to NR. Understand? R plus NR will be approximately equal to small n into small r. Why? Because this R is very small, so R will get neglected. Clear? So, this equation I will turn to I equal to NE divided by NR. Understand? N get cancelled and finally the value is E by R. Okay? E by R. Okay? So, here you can check these two equations. Listen here. In the first case, when the external resistance is greater than internal resistance, the value of current is I is equal to NE by R. Okay. For the second case, when the internal resistance is greater than external resistance. I equal to what? I equal to E by R. Okay. So this is the current drawn for a single cell. You can check the equation. That is E by R for a single cell. Okay. Now in this case, I is equal to N times the value for a single cell. So in which case the current will be more? In the first case. Understand? That is, in the first case, you can see that the external resistance is greater than internal resistance. So in a circuit, in a series combination, if the external resistance is greater than the internal resistance, okay, internal resistance, then we can draw maximum value of current. Clear? But if the internal resistance is greater than the external resistance, the equation will turn to I equal to E by R, which means that it is only the value of a single cell. Why we are getting this equation means E and R are same. For all cells, E is same. For all cells, internal resistance is same. That's why we are getting the equation like this. If these are of different values, equation will also change. So this is a condition where we are taking cells having equal value for EMF as well as internal resistance. And what we have to notice, the main thing or main concept that you are getting from this point is what? If the external resistance is greater than internal resistance, we can draw maximum value of current from the cell. So if you want to draw maximum current from the cell in series combination, the external resistance must be greater than internal resistance. Understand? So that is the point here. Now we will move to the second combination of cells, that is parallel combination of cells. So now we will move to the second combination of cells, that is parallel combination of cells. Okay. So let us consider a few cells like N cells and let us combine or let us group it in parallel combination. Okay. So first of all, we'll consider the cells like this. Since there are N cells, I'm taking like this. Okay. So this is E. All are having the same EMF. All are having the same internal resistance. Now, this combination or this grouping is connected to an external resistance. It is given by capital R. Clear? Now, as you know, current will get divided into three as it is what? Which combination? Parallel combination. Then details of that you know. Everything you know in parallel combination. What is happening for voltage or what is happening for current. Everything you know. Since it is EMF or potential difference, this will be same. Okay, when we take the what effective EMF for parallel combination, the point that you have to notice, the effective value, the effective EMF for parallel combination of cells is that of the value for a single cell. Understand? For a single cell, the EMF is E. Okay? So this will be the what? Effective EMF. If you are finding, no, if you are finding using the expression E minus IR is equal to V, like that, using that expression, if you are finding also, you will get the value as E. That is the effective EMF for parallel combination of cells. Is the value for a EMF of a single cell, which is E. Okay, so for each cell it is E. Effective value is also equal to E. Clear? Now resistance are there. Resistance in parallel combination, you know, you will take the reciprocal. So since this is parallel, I can write RP. Okay, so 1 by RP equal to 1 by R plus 1 by R plus etc. to N cells are there. Isn't it? So the value is 1 by RP is equal to N by R. I can write, no? N by R. So this is the case when we are using the cells having the same internal resistance. If the value changes, we can write like this. Okay. Now, we will substitute in that equation I equal to E by R plus R to find the current drawn from the cell. So when we are substituting, we can write the expression as I is equal to E by R plus R. And what is E here? E is same because E is the value, the effective EMF in parallel combination is that of the EMF of a single cell, which is E itself. So I can write E divided by R external resistance plus what is R here? 1 by RP is N by R. So what is RP? RP is R by N, isn't it? So you can write the expression as R by N. Clear? Now you can cross multiply here and this equation will turn to NE divided by NR plus R. Because this will come here, no? NR plus R by N. N will go there. So NE by NR plus R. So this is the expression or final expression to find the value of current drawn from this cell. NE by NR plus R. Okay. Now we will apply the cases. The first case is, first case is when R is greater than R. That is, external resistance is greater than internal resistance. This equation, in this equation, you can say which term will get neglected? Yes, small r will get neglected. So this will turn to N times R. N times R. Okay. Now I substitute the value here. So I will get like I is equal to N E by N R. N E by N R, which is equal to E by R. Okay. E by R. Second case is, when this small r is greater than N times capital R. Small r is greater than N times capital R. This, in this equation, which term will go? Which term will go? This term will go, isn't it? So, NR plus R will turn to NR. Sorry. Small r. NR plus R will turn to small r. Substituting here, I is equal to NE divided by small r. Now look here, in the first case when capital R is greater than smaller, then when external resistance is greater than internal resistance of the cell, you are getting the current as E by R. And in the second case when the internal resistance is greater than the external resistance, you are getting I equal to NE by R. Okay, that is N times the value of a single current. Understood? That single cell, the value of current for a single cell. So, N times is coming there. That means you can draw maximum value of current in parallel combination when this value of external resistance is less than internal resistance. Or you can say the value of internal resistance is greater than external resistance. Understood? So, this is the condition for parallel combination of cells. Okay? So, easy only, just you want to know certain points. First point is, in the case of parallel combination of cells, the effective EMF is equal to what? E itself. Okay, that is the first point. In second point, you can find the effective value of internal resistance like you have studied before in the case of parallel combination of resistors, and you get the value as Rp equal to R by N. Now substituting in this equation, I equal to E by R plus R, you can write E for E, then R capital R, and instead of small r, you will write the expression as R by N. Just a simplification, applying the two cases, and you can find in which case you can draw maximum value of current from the cell. In which case? In the case of series combination, if the external resistance is more than internal resistance, you can draw maximum current. But in this case, in parallel combination, if the internal resistance is more than the external resistance, you can draw maximum value of current. Clear? Now we will move to the third combination, that is mixed grouping of cells. Mixed grouping of cells. Now the third section is mixed grouping of cells. Okay. In this mixed grouping, actually what we are doing is some cells are connected in series and some cells are connected in parallel. Here also all the cells are having the same EMF, all the cells are having the same internal resistance. Okay, this much clear, no? Now listen. In this figure, you can see that there are N cells. There are N cells in series in one row. Okay. there are n cells here. Now they are series in one row. Each row, if you are taking, they are in series. But when you consider like this, no, there are m rows of cells which are in parallel. Got it? There are n cells in series in each row or one row, and m rows are there in which the cells are connected in parallel. Clear? Here also, what we are going to do is we are finding an expression for I. Okay, before that I have to find the expression for the effective EMF as well as the effective internal resistance. Clear? Now listen, here you can see that in series combination, what is the value for effective EMF? In series combination, the effective EMF is N times E, isn't it? So the effective EMF for the first row, if I am taking, it is NE, isn't it? Again, for the second row, if I am taking, it is also NE. Clear? Like that, if any row I am taking, the value for effective EMF is N times E. Okay. So it is N times E. Clear, no? Now listen, we have to find the effective internal resistance. Effective internal resistance, you know, for the first row, if I am taking, this connection is in series. So what is the effective resistance here? It will be N times R. Clear? Second row also, N times R. Again, N times R. Like that it is going. Okay. So if I am just changing this picture and redrawing, no, just listen here. For the first case, if there is an effective EMF as well as effective resistance, I will get a picture like this. Effective EMF is there, then effective resistance is there. Okay, it is NE and NR, isn't it? Like that for the second row also, I will get like this. NE and NR. And like that I can draw. And now you can consider this as M times this row is coming in parallel combination, isn't it? M times the value of this effective resistance or the effective EMF is coming in parallel combination. This way if you are looking. Understood? Now, how will you write? Listen carefully and say. So, effective EMF is NE and effective resistance for series combination, for the first row it is NR. This much clear. Now, when you go to the second parallel connection, as I earlier told that the value for parallel combination in the case of effective EMF is that of a single cell, isn't it? Since we have the value as N times E, okay, in series combination I have calculated the value as N times E. So, actually I have an effective EMF here for the cell which is NE. Okay, so that will be the value for each row. So when I consider the parallel combination, for each row I have a value of NE and that is the value for parallel also. Understood? So if I write the expression, no, I is equal to, instead of E, I can write this N times E. Are you getting it? So easy only. That is, just take the series combination. First row, you are getting N times E. Again, second also N times E. Like that, for each row you are getting NE, no? But when you move to the parallel, no? Parallel combination, for each circuit if I am taking, what is the value of that particular EMF? That will be the value there for parallel combination. So, since it is NE, I can write it as NE. Okay. Divided by, external resistance is there, that you will write like that, R. Plus, now, we have to find the effective resistance in which combination? Parallel combination. Understand? So, by series combination, I have calculated the effective value of resistance as N times smaller. Isn't it? So, in each row, there is N times smaller. Again, N times smaller. So, how many rows are like that? There are M rows. Clear? So, what is the effective value of resistance? 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by Nr plus 1 by Nr plus etc. to M times, isn't it? M times 1 by Nr. Understood? M times 1 by NR. So, the answer will be M by NR. Clear? M by NR. Why you got NR here? Since they are in series combination, we calculated the effective value for resistance there, which is N times smaller. Okay. Now, our expression is M by NR. This is 1 by RP. So, I have to take the reciprocal to get the value for RP. RP is NR by M. RP is NR by M. Clear? Now, we will take this value here. That is NR by M. Okay. NR by M. Just cross multiplying, you will get NE divided by MR plus NR divided by M. Isn't it? So, M will go up. So, expression is MNE divided by MR plus NR. Okay? MNE by MR plus NR. So, this is the expression for what? The value of current drawn from a cell when we consider the mixed grouping of cells. Okay? Once again, we are taking mixed grouping in which some cells are in series as well as some in parallel. Here you are considering n cells in series in one row. Okay. So in each row you are taking n cells are there. So here you will get the effective EMF as well as effective resistance by considering the cells in series combination. It will be NE and NR. So for each row you are getting NE, NR like that. Isn't it? Now moving to the parallel combination. How many such rows are there in parallel combination? M rows are there. So, you will take, move to the parallel combination means E will remain the same. No? For parallel combination, E is the same. What is the value of a single cell? That will be the value for EMF in a parallel combination. So, the NE is the value here. Now, we are moving to effective resistance. That is 1 by NR plus 1 by NR. Like that it will go. How many times? M times. So, M by NR is the what? 1 by RP. You have to take the reciprocal. So, RP will turn to NR by M. Okay. Substituting here, the expression will change like this. Now, what is our aim? You have to take maximum current from this cell. So, in mixed grouping, if you want to take maximum current from this cell, the value of this particular denominator should be minimum, right? MR plus NR should be minimum. MR plus NR should be minimum so that maximum value of current is drawn from the cell. Isn't it? Maximum value of current is drawn from the cell only when the value of this denominator is minimum. Isn't it? How you can turn this value to a minimum value? Suppose if R is greater than this small r. Again, the sum of these two values will be a higher value. Isn't it? So, what is the condition? What will be the condition? Can you? Yes, the condition is the MR, the value of MR must be equal to value of NR. Okay? Value of MR must be equal to value of NR. That is the only condition where you will get the maximum value of current from the cell. So, you can write MR is equal to NR or sorry N small r, or you can write the value of R. Value of R must be equal to NR by M. The value of R must be equal to NR by M to get a maximum value of current from this cell. Understood? So that's all about mixed grouping of cells. So these are the three conditions or three combination of cells. First is series combination, second is parallel, and third is mixed grouping of cells. So now we are moving to one of the most important sections of this chapter, that is Kirchhoff's laws. Okay, Kirchhoff's laws. Okay, now the introduction of these laws is for the purpose of solving certain electrical circuits. Okay, normally we use Ohm's law to solve the electrical circuits or to find the effective resistance and all. You can do that with the help of Ohm's law. But if certain circuits contain large number of EMF or source of EMF cells and all the complicated circuits, no? In such cases, to solve that particular circuit, we can use this Kirchhoff laws. Okay. This Kirchhoff laws contain two laws. Both are very important. And understand it thoroughly. Okay, clearly you have to understand so that you will be able to solve the numericals. From this section, there will be numericals based on the circuits. The circuits will be given to you and you are asked to solve the circuit to find the current, to find the resistance, to find the voltage, potential difference, like that the questions will be asked. And it will be very easy if you are getting it clearly. Okay, otherwise you will make mistakes. Okay, so understand the concept clearly, then apply to the numericals. First we have to do small circuits, then we will move to the complicated circuits. Understand? So today we are moving to the laws. The first law, Kirchhoff's first law, is what I'm going to discuss now. So Kirchhoff's first law is also known as current law. Okay, Kirchhoff's current law. Clear? Kirchhoff's first law is also known as Kirchhoff's current law. You can call it as KCL. KCL. Okay. Now, what is this law states? The starting, I told that electric current is a which quantity? It is a scalar quantity. Now, what here we are considering is, we are considering a junction. Junction means what? Where so many things are coming, isn't it? You know junction, normal junction you know. In the case of current also, there will be in a particular circuit, there will be certain junctions from which the current leaves or to which the current is coming. For example, if there is a point like this, okay, and currents are coming from different directions. Let this be I1, I2, I3 leaving the junction, I4 leaving the junction, okay, I5 entering the junction, again I6 entering the junction. So here this is the junction, let it be A. Okay, so when I consider this particular junction, so many currents are coming towards the junction as well as some currents are leaving the junction, isn't it? According to this law, according to Kirchhoff's first law, the algebraic sum of electric current in a junction is zero. The algebraic sum of the electric current in a junction is zero. That is, summation over I is equal to zero. Clear? Now, here some current are coming to the junction and a few currents are leaving the junction, isn't it? So let us consider the sum of sum of the currents coming to the junction. Clear? So first of all, I1 is coming here towards A. Okay. Now second current is I2 coming here. Okay. Then I6 coming here. I5 coming here. Okay, now these are the currents coming towards the junction. Now by sign convention, the current leaving the junction is taken as negative. The current coming towards the junction is taken as what? Positive. And the current leaving the junction is taken as negative. So what are the currents leaving the junction? That is minus I3 and minus I4. Why I put minus here? Because these I3 and I4 are leaving the junction. Isn't it? Now according to the law, the algebraic sum of the electric current in a junction is zero. So I can put what? Zero here. Clear? Clear now? Okay. Now I1 plus I2 plus I5 plus I6 is equal to I3 plus I4. I can write now here. Now listen, these are the currents entering the junction. Isn't it? So current entering the junction is equal to what? These are the currents leaving the junction. Current leaving the junction. Okay, so Kirchhoff's first law states that the algebraic sum of the electric current in a junction is zero. So how much current is entering into this particular junction? That particular amount is leaving the junction. Understand? So the current entering the junction is equal to the current leaving the junction. In other words, we can say like that, the current entering the junction is equal to the current leaving the junction. Now by sign convention, the current entering the junction is taken as positive and current leaving the junction is taken as negative. Understood? Now, here, for example, if I am taking a question like, look here 5 ampere and 4 ampere are coming towards the junction, isn't it? But 2 ampere and I are leaving the junction. If you are asked to find the value 5, you can easily find it out. How? By taking the sum of the currents leaving the junction and taking the sum of the currents entering the junction, isn't it? So 5A plus 4A, isn't it? This is the junction here. So 5A and 4A are coming towards the junction and 2A and I are leaving. So this must be equal to what? 2A plus I. Okay, 5A plus 4A is 9A. 9A minus 2A. A is the ampere unit, which is equal to I, and I is equal to what? 7 ampere. Understood? So this way you can find the value of currents entering or leaving the junction. When we discuss the numericals, we will look into it more. Okay. Actually, this Kirchhoff's first law is giving the conservation of what? Conservation of charge. You have studied the conservation of charge, where charge is neither created nor destroyed. Listen, it is conserved. So, how much current is what? Charged by time. So, how much charge flowing through this particular line towards the junction is leaving there without any creation or without any destruction. Understand? So this is also considered as the conservation of charge. Kirchhoff's first law is applicable or applied where? As the conservation of charge. Understand? So that's all about Kirchhoff's first law. Now we are moving to Kirchhoff's second law. Now, we are moving to the second law, Kirchhoff's second law. Kirchhoff's second law is also known as Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay, first law was known as Kirchhoff's current law. Here, KVL. Okay, first one was KCL and now this is KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law. Also known as loop rule or mesh rule. Loop rule or mesh rule. Clear? First law is also known as current law, or one more name is there. I forgot to mention that. That is junction rule. Okay. Junction rule. So first rule is also known as junction rule or current law. Clear? Second law is known as voltage law or loop rule, or otherwise known as mesh rule. So what is this loop or what is this mesh? So in complicated circuits, we have to consider that particular circuit, or we have to divide that circuit into different loops, closed loops. Understand? And by taking the closed loop, we have to apply the Kirchhoff's second law. For example, I will consider a diagram here. Let us consider. Okay, let this is our circuit. I name this particular circuit like A, B, C, D, E, and F. Clear? Now, according to this particular law, second law, I will state the law first. According to this law, in any closed loop, the algebraic sum of the product of current and resistance, the algebraic sum of the product of current and resistance is equal to the algebraic sum of the EMF in that loop. Understand? So in any closed loop, the algebraic sum of the product of current and resistance, you know, product of current and resistance means IR. What is IR? IR is the potential or potential difference, isn't it? So I can say that the summation of this IR, for any closed loop. Look here, I can divide this particular circuit into two loops. This is my first loop and this is my second loop. Loop means starting from A, then B, then C, D, and coming back to A. Okay, again, next loop, D, C, F, E, D. So, I can consider two loops here. And if I consider this particular loop, A, B, C, D, A, what is the law? The algebraic sum of the product of current and resistance. The product of current and, for example, here one current is flowing like this is I1. Okay. Now here it is I2. And anyway it will come here and divide. No? So I name it as I3. So here I1, I2, I3. Now, this I1 is actually flowing from the positive of the cell to this particular resistance, right? So, this particular R1 carries a current of I1. So, there is a potential, isn't it? So, I1 into R1 is the potential here. So, I can take for this particular loop, I1, R1. Understand? Here, I1, R1. Then again, plus, we are taking the summation, right? Then again, this I1 will come like this. Okay. Now when it enters here, I3 is the new current. So I3 R2. Okay. Then again if I am completing this particular loop, means you can see that we are moving from, suppose I am moving like this. Okay. It is your option that you can move in a clockwise or anti-clockwise order. Okay, clockwise movement or anti-clockwise movement, it is your wish. You can select that. Then when you are taking a loop and moving, no, the way you move or the direction you move is actually the direction of the current. That means if you are moving like this and the current is also in that direction, means you can take current as positive. Understand? Now if you are moving like this but the current is in opposite direction in that circuit, means the current is taken as negative. Understood? So here you can choose the loops. The loop must be closed. Okay. How will you take the direction of current? You can take the direction of current in the direction that you are moving. If the direction given of current given in the diagram is along the direction that you are moving, you can take that particular direction as a direction of current. Current is taken as positive. Now, if you are moving like this, if you selected the loop and you move like this, but the direction of current in the diagram is opposite to that, your movement means you have to take it as negative. Clear? Now, listen. So, you can move like this, I3, R2, okay, is equal to, what? According to this rule, this is equal to the algebraic sum of the EMF in that loop. Algebraic sum of the EMF in that loop. So for this particular loop, you can see that, look here, if you are moving like this, it is moving from a negative terminal to positive terminal, right? You are moving like this means negative terminal to positive terminal. What does it mean? Yes, it is gain, voltage gain. From negative to positive means voltage is gaining. Two types of potential difference can happen. What are they? Voltage gain as well as voltage loss. Isn't it? Both are there. Drop is there, also gain is there. So moving from negative to positive means voltage gain is happening. Moving from positive to negative means voltage drop is happening. So here it is moving from negative to positive, which will give you plus, plus even. This is how we are selecting the sign of what? EMF. So it is plus E1. Clear? So first, this is for the first loop. Understand? For the loop A, B, C, B, A. This is the loop. Okay. So if you are considering this loop, you can say that the current, if you are taking the direction of current like this, you are moving like this. That is why you are taking the direction of current as positive. Suppose if I move like this, no? I moved like this. Means in this way, that is from A, B, C, like that if I move, I have to take the direction of current as negative. Understood? So just understand the concept and then apply. So as per this rule, I can write this equation for this loop. Clear? If I am selecting the second loop, this is my second loop. For example, this is my second loop. Now look here, if I am moving like this, I can either move like this or you can move like this, no problem, you can select. And just keep in mind that the how, which direction that you are selecting, you have to take the direction of current in such a way, that's all. Okay, so if I am moving like this, you can say that here the current is I3, R2, isn't it? I3, R2, then moving like this. Now look here. It is going from negative to positive, which means that it is again voltage gain, voltage gain. So you can write it as E2, isn't it? Plus E2. Now again the current coming here is I2, no? I2R3, isn't it? I2R3. So again plus I2R3. Clear? Plus I2R3. Understand? So the equation is I3R2 plus I2R3. Which is equal to E2. Now what you have to do is you have to solve the equation. But in this particular condition, there are currents like I1, I3, I2, etc. No? So the easier way is to make the two equations in terms of any two currents. That is I1, I2 or I2, I3, anything like that. So here again one problem is there. Look here, this I1 is coming to this particular junction, isn't it? Again, I2 is coming to this particular junction. But here, the current I3 is flowing. Isn't it? It is clear that when two currents come to a junction, the sum of the currents entering the junction is equal to sum of the current leaving the junction. So here, you can frame one equation using our Kirchhoff's first law. That is I1 plus I2 is equal to I3. Okay? I1 plus I2 is equal to I3. Understand? Now you can take any two and you can substitute here. Then you can solve. So solving and the numerical part we will discuss in the next class. Just understand the law. First law, I think it is clear for you. First law means what? It is the algebraic sum of the current over a junction is equal to 0. Or the sum of current entering the junction is equal to sum of current leaving the junction. It is actually in accordance with the conservation of charge. Okay. Now this law, that is Kirchhoff's second law, also known as the voltage law or loop rule or mesh rule, anything you can call. This law is actually in accordance with the conservation of energy. Because you know, the potential, the definition of potential says that it is the work done to move a charge from one point to another. What actually you are doing here is, you are taking a closed loop, no? So starting from A and coming back to A means, what is the potential difference here? VA minus VA, which is equal to 0. The potential difference is 0. So no work is done. Okay, work is not done. That means conserved. The energy is conserved there. Clear, no? So, this particular second law is in accordance with the conservation of energy. And what does the law state? It says that in any closed loop, algebraic sum of the product of current and resistance is equal to the algebraic sum of the EMF in that loop. Understand? So, this is how you are doing the problems. So, in the next class, we will discuss more numericals. So, you have to study it clearly. then only you will be able to do the numericals, and by practicing numericals only you will be able to do it in the board exams. Understand? So I think today's topic, all the topics are very important, especially the combination of cells and Kirchhoff's laws. Go through the laws clearly and study it properly. Okay, so we will meet after the autumn vacation. So happy autumn to all of you, and thank you.